if Ken were to do a vinegar product, it would be balsamic vinegar. It's an incredible product, well matured, gives it in oak barrels, gives a great deal of sweetness, a great deal of body to it, as well as having the acidity you would expect from vinegar. And this is from Modena. So we comply with all the PDOs in terms of origin, and this is just incredible stuff used by lots of people now in cooking, salad dressings, etc., etc. Now for all our seasonings having to be in dry powder form, this would be done in as much that that would then be in an emulsion in liquid form. It would be under pressure, put through fine jets which would atomize that into a warm drum, which would then turn all those atomized particles into powder, and we'd actually have balsamic vinegar powder. And so there's the vinegar, and there you go. That is exactly that liquid in powder form. And again, if you tasted that, you would see how similar they are. But in some respects, because of the process, there are some nuances which I think you lose. And there are two things that I think you lose, and you want to get the flavor profile absolutely right. First is the acidity. We lose a little bit of the acidity through the spray drying process. That's the reason that I'm using another ingredient, which is malt vinegar. Malt vinegar, again, a very different vinegar, much sharper, with that hint of malt. So we would just use this malt vinegar. So it's standard malt vinegar powder, but in the same way I can't use it like that, I would then have it in powdered form. And we'd spray dry that exactly the same way. And there you go. That is malt vinegar powder. Now that enables me then to bring back some of the acidity that I've lost from the balsamic vinegar. And then the other thing, of course, is there's a great deal of sweetness in this product, but we lose a little bit of the sweetness, so we have sugar. We want salt in the product, because it is salt and balsamic vinegar. This is, again, natural sea salt from the Mediterranean, sun-dried, nothing added, nothing taken away from it. And then the final thing is, to help us in terms of the spray drying of the balsamic vinegar, as it's liquid form in that regard, we actually do put in, when we spray dry it, a little bit of potato maltodextrin. Potato maltodextrin basically is the sugar from the potatoes. So it's actually already in these potatoes. All it is the sugar element of those potatoes is a dextrin. So, and they are, in actual fact, just the five ingredients that go into making that. Now the key to that, of course, is I want people to be able to eat it as sea salt and balsamic vinegar. So it's like putting a recipe together. You know, I need so much of the salt, I need so much of the balsamic vinegar, and I need so much of the sweetness and the acidity to give me a three-dimensional eating experience of salt and balsamic vinegar. All right, that takes time, and there'll be lots of tries at getting it right and not getting it right. But at the end of the day, when I do get it right and I get the flavour profile I'm looking for, these elements are then blended together, yeah, to make the seasoning that we're going to use. And if we get it right and we agree on it, that in actual fact is sea salt and balsamic vinegar. The same powder, the same way put onto the chips that you've seen earlier, which is just sprinkled onto our hand-cut potato chips. And there you go.